God for allowing us to wake up today, starting us on our way, giving us all the activities of our limbs. I love this song. Giving us the activities of our limbs, showing us a brand new day that was not promised to us. He didn't recycle yesterday and give it back to us again today. He gave us a brand spanking new day. Like, it's a new day to get it right, to get it straight, to fix any issues, any problems, anything that's going on. He's giving you today to correct it, to fix it, to be better. And I pray that you're wanting to be better. You want greatness. You want more. You want better. You want positive things happening for you. I pray that everything is going well for you. We're staying safe as much as we possibly can. Staying positive as possibly as we can. As most as we can. As much as we can. And this is Pastor John B. King. At the Cross. That's the name of it. But we're grateful to God for what he's doing, what he's getting ready to do, how he's about to do it, what he's about to provide for us. He's about to show us some new stuff that we didn't even know that God could do. We still got some doubt, but God about to show us some new stuff that you haven't even witnessed yourself, but you're getting ready to witness it. You're getting ready to see God's work. You're getting ready to see his awesomeness even more in different ways. And I love that.
Great and unexpected things that I could never think of that he can actually do for me. I expect those things. I want God to, but I have to have that mindset of positive things that I'm going to have a good day. I'm not going to be involved in, you know, I'm going to do me. I'm going to set myself up for some great goals, and those goals is going to come into pass because I've willing to have the positive mindset that God is going to do it. And I know he's going to do it. He don't never leave me nor forsake me. He is always there. In a time of need or even when I don't even think about it, he's taking care of me. Like I said a long time ago, God watches over us while we slumber and sleep. Why am I walking the floor all night long? And God can, God is the one that's working. If he's up working doing his job, I need to go to bed. I turned it over to him and he's already working it out. So I'm not going to even worry about things that I can't control, things that I don't have to be a part of, because God is already doing it. When you turn it over to him, he's already going to work it out. He's already going to do it. You just got to trust and believe in that. But he's just that wonderful God that he does some great things for us. I pray that y'all have been downloading the podcast, God's Day podcast. I will attach the information to this live so that you can click on it and you can start listening in. God's Day, y'all. Okay, I can see y'all. Blessings. How are you? God's Day. Hold on. Y'all know what I got to do. Give me a second. Yes, let me have a number 7 with cheese. Absolutely. Let me get a strawberry with no ice, please. And you know what? That's gonna be all. Thank you. How are y'all being? How are y'all? Give me a second. I'm about to pull my app up and show it to them and good stuff. But I am grateful to where God is, what he's getting ready to do. I'm excited about that. But I was telling y'all about the podcast. If you have not been downloading the podcast episodes, you can start today. Like I said before, I'm going to attach the link to the podcast to this live, so that you can just click on it and download whatever media platform you want to download the podcast to from. You are more than welcome to do that.
Good morning.
Good morning. Okay. Sorry. Okay, let me give you.
And are you paying with that?
No. Right. I'm just letting you scan it. Sorry, y'all. Y'all know how my morning routine go. Sorry. I thought I was more prepared than I was, but I guess I wasn't. But this press is not that big, so I don't know. That's what it is. They wrap my receipts up. There you go. Thank you. Okay, so as I was stating, you absolutely know you're right. Thank you. You already know me. You already know where I'm at. Anyway, download the episodes. Podcast is on all of your, I found that it was some more that we're a part of as far as podcasting. So if you would like to be a guest on a podcast, just email me at godsday81@gmail.com and you can be a guest on the podcast, the Godsday podcast. Talk about any and everything. As long as it's something positive, or you trying to talk about your business, or you trying to do something that is helping or supporting, you got a food drive, you got something going on that can help the community, let's talk about it. Let's put it out there. Let's support each other, as well as advertising your business on the godsday81.com. Website under advertisements. It has been updated as of yesterday, and that way you can go out there and look at new businesses that are out there, new information that is out there. I have been posting jobs. People may be in need of jobs, so I've been posting that. If you have that type of information, nonprofit organizations, jobs, businesses, churches, any of that information is on godsday81.com. You can go there, look at those advertisements. You can network with those people, or you can add your own information on there as well. But you have to email me, godsday81@gmail.com. godsday81@gmail.com. I will post that information on here. So you could just click on it, and then it will take you directly to my email address, as well as the website and other information. Like I said, the podcast information is there, and all of those good things. If you have something, you have product that you want me to try out, to review for you, and to discuss it and get people to come and to support you with your product, whatever it is, I don't care what it is. If you have product that you want me to talk about and to get people to come and be a part of your business and say, hey, oh, I like this. This is really good, because y'all know I talk about everybody. Like this lovely necklace that I have on, I got from Awana Braxton Morgan with Heavenly Anointed Jewels for $5. She is a wonderful independent paparazzi consultant with Paparazzi. Check her out. Her information is on the GodSay81.com website. All you have to do is go to her GodSay81.com. And her information is there. There are multiple people that are paparazzi consultants that are there, but you can pick whoever you want to. They have a website. Their website information is there, as well as their Facebook page, their social media page. These earrings I got from my beautiful sister. These are a pair of her earrings that she had. But that's why I didn't tell y'all about it. But y'all know I'm going to tell y'all about Miss Tracy. Miss Tracy Green with BWA Stylish Way. She got everything you need from the top of your head to the sole of your feet. You need a headband. You need some hair, like a wig or whatever. Some glasses, some earrings, a necklace, a bracelet, rings, whatever. A purse. My purse is open. But I got this from Miss Tracy Green. Ain't this cute? Isn't she pretty? She cute? So please check her out. I promise you would not be disappointed with her customer service. You would not be disappointed with her products. She's a quick shipper. I don't wonder, you know, last time I talked about quick shipping, you know. But quick shipping, she's really on point when it comes down to that. She's great with her customer service. She's on point with everything. So check out Miss Tracy Green, BWA Stylish Way. Her information is on my GodSay81.com page under advertisements. Again, if you go to the advertisement page on GodSay81.com, you will see all that information there, as well as when you go to that website, the email subscribers list, please be a part of that. I'm doing a drawing for those that will sign up to be a part of our email subscribers list. You never know what happens with guys. They, any new product, any new blog posting, any new thing, weekly encouragements, all that good stuff, I post that information there first for those that are a part of the email subscribers list. Spicy ketchup, please. They are part of that. So I do that, as well as the podcasting. Like, again, that information will be posted on here. And you too. Thank you. That information will be posted on here. And sorry. Have to make sure. They disappointed me the last couple of days, so I have to make sure before I pull all the way away. Listen. Just to get your whole life in order. Don't judge me, because I do eat, you know, a burger every now and again. I will eat a burger with some, serious onions on there. I do eat the burgers this time of morning. So, and she is right. That is Whataburger that I have been, that I'm with right now. So, but anyway. We're gonna, so I just wanted to make sure that I let you all know that, learn something positive or whatever that we can discuss and put out there for other people to see. Like I said a long time ago, let's support each other as much as we possibly can and be there for each other as much as we possibly can. We are going through a lot. There's things that are happening that is a lot. And, what you need more support of, and I'm not even talking about, just business-wise or finances or whatever. It's just talking about having that shoulder to cry on, or having someone to talk to when you're going through, when you're in need, because there is a lot of things. Girl, listen. And I used to couldn't stay in that place. Like, I couldn't do it. And I don't even know why. I didn't like it. And then now, I find myself here just about every day. Just about. Okay? Those 9 months I was at home working from home, I didn't come up here. So now, yeah, things have changed. I'm back. But now we'll see what's gonna happen. So that's what I was saying, because I'm hearing, I'm, you know, talking to different people. They're talking about it may shut back down. We may go back to what we were a few months ago. And if that's the case, let's just make sure that we're prepared and we're ready. Let's not be greedy, because there have been a lot of greedy people. When this first happened, you go into the shelves and there was nothing there. And people were just buying stuff just to be buying it. You didn't even need it. You just in the store just buying up stuff because you feel like, I don't want nobody else to have it. And or I don't want to, come on, let's be able to share this with somebody. You have people that are, you have elderly parents that have elderly parents, or they are elderly and they need those things, that we don't went in there and bought everything up. And with them being on fixed income, they cannot have it like you, you know, can't go in there and just buy it up like that or buy a bunch of things. I told y'all about a month ago, I believe, I'm not sure what podcast it's on, which episode it's on, but I believe about a month ago, I started saying, y'all need to start back preparing yourself just in case it does go shut back down. I think everything opened up back up too quick. I think we are after money. I know a lot of people don't like to hear that, but what doesn't all boil down to money? When our kids are going to school and folks, they're studying, shutting down schools every now and again, they're shutting down another school and shutting down another school. And with them shutting down schools the way that they have been doing, our kids are just being like guinea pigs and just let it going. And you know, smaller kids don't know to, you know, watch the, they still learning. So we put that on them. That's a lot. And but it's because we want the money that the government is giving us. I said, I don't mind. We want the money that the government is giving us. And when we after that, do you really care about somebody's life? Like I've said before, a while back, when you have these things that's going on and it turns into a money situation, you don't care about nobody's well-being. You're not no good if you sick or you dead. How you, then where is the money? Because now either you sick or you dead. And in the words of my good friend, Bishop Smith, it got to make sense. It got to make sense. Like if it don't make sense, what are we doing it for? Why are we dealing with it? What are we doing? Because when you think about it, reality is, if you're holding that over my head, I won't fund you because you won't go to school. You won't send your kids to school. They let me know right there, you don't care about my well-being. You don't care about my life. You don't care about my child's life. That you got to hold that over my head. I'm not going to give you this because you're not sending your child to school to get sick. Instead of them just staying at home. And I know it's different. I know a lot of people are hands-on. They like to be shown hands-on because I'm one of them kind. Certain things, you got to show me hands-on. Be like, mm-hmm, I heard what you said. Show me, though. And then I know it's challenging, even with the teachers, the administrators, with life, you know, even our jobs, they're trying to figure it out. And I know everybody don't have the right answer because they have not been through this before. So you don't have the right answer, but you're trying. And the things that we're getting is nothing because we've been, you like I said, either you sick or you taking a chance of that because you wanted to be funded or you want them to help you out. And it shouldn't be that. We trust in God. We put our faith in God. God gonna do it. He gonna work it out. He gonna fix whatever problems or situation or issues we going through. He gonna do it. But we, like I said before, we got to trust and believe that he's gonna do it. And a lot of times we don't want to do that. If you have not read the latest blog that I put, it's a weekly encouragement blog that I put, I think it was 2 days ago, but I posted about it just to let y'all know that blog is out there. And it's, are you a helpful neighbor? Your friend is in need or your neighbor is in need. I'm not talking about somebody next door to you. I'm talking about anybody you come in contact with. Are you a helpful neighbor? Are you a person that assists your sister or brother when they're in need? You have something that they can use and you don't want to give it up because you don't want to let that go. You blocking your blessing by not trying to help somebody else out. We're coming into God's Day Whispers. We're coming into a time where being thankful and being grateful. And I was thinking about it this morning. I was saying, why do we always have like coat drives and food drives and blanket drives and stuff like that just during the winter? Like, what are people supposed to do from January to October until Thanksgiving or whatever comes around? What are they supposed to do? We only picking and choosing that time. Like, you only need blankets at that time or whatever. I don't know. Don't judge me on that. I'm just saying. There's people need food all the time. People need assistance all the time. Are you a helpful neighbor? Do you assist somebody when you know they're in need? I'm not saying give up everything that you have. I'm not saying that you have to spend your whole check on somebody. I'm not saying you got to give up everything in your house for somebody. What I'm saying is, when you have something that you're able to help somebody else with, are you helping them with it? Are you a great, are you a helpful neighbor? Are you a person that assists your friends or assists somebody, a stranger, when they're in need? You have it, but you won't share. You have it, but you won't assist with it. You have the resources. And I've told you, you don't even have to read the blog, my encouragement blog, this week's weekly encouragement blog. Are you a helpful neighbor? Doesn't mean that you have the money, but you have resources. You have the means. You can get in contact with somebody that can help that person out or that can assist them in what they need. And a lot of times we don't want to do that because that's why I said, even with jobs, like the job information I've been posting, I was posting that information because I don't know who may need it. Somebody may need, maybe looking for a job, but to me, that's resources. That's helpful to somebody. The more we help somebody to go and get their own, that way they can go, they can be of assistance to them own, to their own selves. You don't have to worry about them coming for or coming to ask you for anything, or for them to be out here robbing and stealing or whatever because they're out here getting it themselves. So if you, again, if you have job information, I don't care what city or state that you're in, I don't care what area you come from or what you're doing. If your job is hiring, if you are hiring, if you're looking for somebody to assist you with whatever, send me that information on what you're looking for. Let's put that information on our website, guysday81.com, and let's get you the help that you need. Either way, whether you're looking for a job or you're looking to hire someone, send me that information, guysday81@gmail.com. guysday81@gmail.com, and say, hey, I'm looking to hire an administrative assistant. I'm looking to hire a cook or whatever. Whatever it is. Or you've seen job information or a job fair, or you know of somebody that's hiring. Like I said, I posted the information on my guysday81.com under advertisements. And I have a friend of mine, Michelle Ivy with Ivy Financial Consultants. She is looking to train tax professionals, tax preparer professionals. So if you're looking to do taxes this coming up, income tax season, you can get in contact with her. She will teach you on how to become a great tax preparer professional. And all you have to do is, the information is on guysday81.com. You can click on the link that is attached to that. And again, it's called Ivy Financial Consultants. You click on that link and it's going to take you to her website. She's going to let you know what, and also other job information that you may be in need of through Ivy Financial Consultants. And again, that is information that you can use. Again, you got job information, you got job fair, you know if somebody is hiring, you know your friend is looking for somebody to assist them, being a nanny or a housekeeper, whatever, check them out. Like I said before, if you have product, you have apparel, t-shirt, whatever, and you would like me to discuss or wear your product, please send me the information. Let me know what you want to do. guysday81@gmail.com, guysday81@gmail.com, and we can set something up so we can do that. Last week I wore a blue shirt. It was heaven sent cleaning and organization. That is Gabby Williams with Heaven Sent Cleaning and Organization. She cleans, young lady been cleaning for a little while, or for a good minute, and she's really great at what she does. You need some closet organization, you need garage cleaning out, you need some laundry done, deep cleaning, any of those things. Her information is on the guysday81.com website under advertisements. Her Facebook page information is there. You will be able to get in contact with her, and you will be able to use her services if needed. And like I said before, maybe you don't need it. Maybe it's somebody you know that needs that information. I know she was doing a, choosing a family to clean for, like a makeover cleaning. And it had the details were there on her website. But all you have to do, again, if you can't remember who I said, go to the advertisement page on guysday81.com and click on the information, the links that are provided, and you will be able to go to that person's business page or their Facebook page or their website, and you'll be able to assist, see what they have and get the assistance that you need. That is really great for those that may be in need. Again, you got something you want me to do a review on, send me the information, guysday81.com, guysday81@gmail.com. Please don't forget to download the podcast information. podcast episodes. I do have some more that I have to upload, but for now, there are some that are on there, and I will be posting that information attached to this video. So you can just click on it. Any information you want your business to be advertised, send me the information at guysday81.com, your church, your nonprofit organization, your events. You have an event that's coming up. You have something that needs to be, you need support from other people outside of your norm. Again, send me the information, guysday81@gmail.com. That's guysday81@gmail.com. I want y'all to have an amazing day. But in order for you to have an amazing day, to have that mindset, you have to believe it and have that mindset. Don't go into a space or answer when you got up today, your mindset was, what happened on yesterday, or she said this to me, or they said that. Don't go back to that. Go back, and this sun is really beaming. You hear me? It is really coming on now. Okay. So don't go with that mindset that I'm going to go back to what I was on yesterday. That's all. We're moving on from it today. And so God gave us a brand new day to fix things that we got wrong on yesterday. He's giving us today to fix it. It's okay to ask for forgiveness or to tell somebody you forgive them. It's okay. How many times have our God forgiven us? How many times has he done it? Unlimited times, right? Like, he forgive you when you're wrong, even when you don't want to admit it. God has forgiven you. Why can't you forgive your sister, your brother, when they hurt you, when they done something wrong to you, when they said something wrong to you, they sent you a message, you didn't like what they said, it was some he say, she say stuff, and God has just brought you, he forgave you for the things that you've done to him, and he wants you to forgive your sister or your brother. It doesn't hurt. Yeah, it doesn't hurt for you to do it, but it does hurt on what the person has done to you, that betrayal, that trust, that misunderstanding, that miscommunication, whatever that was. God's telling you to go ahead and fix it. It's too much happening out here, and people are not getting an opportunity to fix things that they should have fixed before things happen to them. You have that opportunity today. You still breathing. You still on top of the dirt. The dirt ain't on top of you. You still in your right frame of mind. You still got all the activities of your limb. You still showing, God is still showing you something brand new. You're still able to see. You're still able to hear. You're still able to taste. Some people don't even have taste buds. When I tell you, I will say this, that I've been hearing a lot about this virus, even after people have contracted it or got it or whatever. What has happened is the after effect. So even when you're thinking, okay, well, I'm feeling better. Y'all, I'm finna stop because I didn't tighten it up. I apologize. And y'all can take it for whatever it's worth. I know a lot of people don't believe that the coronavirus is real. Okay. That's to each his own. That's on you. If that's the way you feel, I'm not making nobody believe that. I'm not making nobody go with that. But for those that I know that have been through it or going through it now, I will say the effect is more devastating than you think of. Oh, you think it's a little cold. It's a little cough. I don't want to wear a mask. My kids don't have to. We just going to be out here just living life like it's not real. Please let me just say this, and this is not something that I heard. This is things that I've seen. Not only that I've heard, but I've also that I've seen. But I will say that people that have had it, I have talked to, have been going through after effect. Like, they're still affected by it, and it's been months later. I was hearing somebody talking about they know somebody that has been paralyzed from it. So that's why I said, don't even think that because you just, this is out here willy-nilly because I'm young, because this don't even, no, don't take it into that effect. Take this serious. If y'all did not see how many people have passed away from this, y'all did not see how many people that are dealing with this kind of stuff. People are still having an after effect where their kidneys is still bothering them after they have gotten the virus. They have gotten the virus multiple times. They have been dealing with their liver. They have been dealing with pains in their legs. They have been dealing with being paralyzed. They have been dealing with all of these things. So yes, take it serious. Even if you don't believe that it is or not, please wear your mask. Do what you're supposed to do. If a job or a business is requiring you to wear the mask or to do something of that, please do that. This is really serious. Don't think because you're 16, you're 21, you're 25 that this won't touch you. A lie. Again, a lie. Don't be so clueless to life to where you think that you can't be touched, that death won't tap on your shoulder. If it's not the coronavirus, it can be anything. There's no time, there's not, and you know, death is random. So it's not going to wait until you turn 62 and say, oh, well, you old enough now. Let me go on and get. No. It's just randomly. It's random. We don't know when. God does not tell us when. We don't know our death date. If we did, I promise you, if we knew that, we'll act up until that time come, and then we'll get our life in, right on time. If we knew that December 31st was our last day, if we knew it, we'll be doing everything else until that time come. Then we'll realize, you know what? Let me go and get my life right, because I got 2 more days. Let me go and turn my life over to the Lord. But see, that's why he's telling you now. We don't know the day. We don't know the day nor the hour. We have no idea. And since we don't know, let's be prepared for ourselves to see Jesus again. Let's be prepared to just do this to get our life to be better than what we have been. But again, don't think that because this has not affected your house or it has not affected your family in any type of way that it's not real. I know of people. Okay. I see. I just got a message. I'm sorry. There are people that I know, that's what I'm telling y'all, that have after effect of getting this virus, and people that have gotten it more than once. And they in their late 20s, early 30s. So it's not having a time. It's not waiting until you turn a certain age. No. Let's be careful out here. Let's wash our hands. Let's put these masks on. And don't put your mask down here. I got to put mine on to walk in this building. Don't have your mask down here, okay? This ain't doing you no good when you're doing this. I know it's hard because I'm not one that would like to wear this mask. And then I got to walk and then I take the stairs. And it's a lot of you trying to breathe. I got glasses on. I got earrings on, an AirPod. All this. If y'all go back to my GuysDay81.com page. I talked about these masks months ago. I did a blog on masks. And I'm just like, baby, it's too much. I got hair. I got earrings. Then I got this headband on. It's a lot. Trying to walk. Trying to cover it. And then people, you know, it's too much. Glasses. It's a lot. Okay? So, but to be safe and to make sure that we're not making our families change in a matter of minutes because we want to take our mask off our face too early or we want to walk into a space. Like I was having a conversation with somebody the other day and I was telling people, I was telling them that we don't know. Somebody could, with us not having our mask on like we should, if you're walking down an aisle and somebody just sneezed, but you don't know they sneezed, and your mask is down and you walked in that same space that they're in, that's how easy it is. You may not want to think about it like that. You don't know how far back or when they sneezed. Did they cover their mouth? If they didn't cover their mouth, it's in the air and it don't came towards you, and now it don't went up in your face. Let's cover up. Let's make sure that we're good. Let's make sure everybody is good. Again, if y'all have information that can assist somebody with rent, that can assist somebody with light bills, with electric bills, that can assist somebody with anything that they need, let's do that. I'm hearing another shutdown. If that's the case, let's make sure everybody is good, that they have food, that they in this wintertime, that lights are not getting cut off, that people are or having the necessities that they need. So if don't matter what state or city that you're in, if you have information, if you are a person that has information, that's your job. You get information. You say, hey, we're looking for this, or we can help with that, or whatever, some type of way, some type of funding, some type of help. Please send the information to me. Let's tell people what's going on. Let's tell people what the resources is. Let's help these people get the things that they need. Again, you don't know. You may be sitting in those shoes. You may feel like you're on top of the world and you got it all together. It takes one situation to change your life. One. You can have it. I promise you. You can have life just, hey, I got this. And it takes one small situation to change your whole life. Just one. That's all it takes. And it could change your life for the good or for the bad. And if it changes it for the bad, or do you know what to do to get out of it? Don't brag about where you are now, because you don't know where God can take you. He could take everything away just like he gave it to you. If you don't know, go read the book of Job. Go read the story on Job on how God, he had everything and he had it all taken away from him. People tell him, you got to cuss God and die. Won't you just let this just be whatever it is? He don't took all these things away from you. He don't took all your land and cattle. He don't did all this stuff. And you still going to trust and believe in God? Absolutely. Absolutely. Guess why? I know that's wrong, but I'm saying it like that. Guess why? Because he trusted God. And we believe that when we got our bank accounts is on point and we got all these people that support us, we feel like we don't, hey, God say whisper. We feel like when life is going good for us, we don't need God. Don't turn your back on him. I'm telling you, it takes one small incident, one small thing to change your life, and you can have it all together before that happens. One thing can change your whole life. Are you ready? Are you prepared? Are you, or can you see what the future holds? Do you know where God is taking you? Don't brag about the things that you have. Folks do that. They'll get on social. I got this, I got that. And it takes one small incident to change your whole life. And all it takes is something like this virus. But let me say this. People think that because I ain't getting the virus that you can't die. You can still die from something. I don't know why people forgetting about that. You can still die from cancer, diabetes, or heart attack, or stroke. Don't think that it's just the virus. I ain't got the virus, so I ain't going to die. No, there's other ways you can die. You see all these shootings that's happening? You see all these other things that are happening? It's because there's other ways that you can die. But are you ready? Are you prepared? Do you have your life in order? Are you good with God? You on the same page? You and God got that full understanding that you say, if God, if you take me right now, I know that I'm going with you. If you don't, get your life together. It takes a second to say, Lord, I surrender all to you. I'm giving, turning my life over to you. I want you to have everything. I want you to be the head of everything. I want you to lead me. I want you to block out anything that does not seem like you, that's not like you. The people that are not for me, for you, that's going for where I'm trying to go with you, block that. Take that away from me. I don't need that. Get rid of that from me. I block all the things that are not of you. I don't want to be a part of it. I don't want them to be a part of me if that's gonna stop me from seeing who you are. I got to get this thing for real, and I got to get it for myself. Time is winding up. We still playing. We still think we got time. We still feel like we too young. We feel like, look at what's happening around you. Look at everything that's been happening in your city, in your neighborhood. Look at the news itself. If you watch any type of news, look at what's happening. What's been happening? What's been going on? How things been happening? Look at those things and see how things can transpire and change in a matter of seconds. We got to do better. We can do better. We're wonderful people. We're great people. You're a handsome person. You're a pretty person. You got some good things going for you. That confidence level, that little smidgen of, I'm just holding back. Don't hold back that confidence. Step out there. Prove people wrong. You ain't got to prove nobody wrong, but, you know, prove yourself wrong and say, I didn't think I can do it, but I did it. But you got to have that confidence. You got to have that mindset. You got to have that whole thing together. Say, I'm on a straight and narrow, and I know God is going to take me through what I need to go through to get where I need to be. You're going to have storms? Absolutely. You're going to go through some stuff? Absolutely. That's a part of it. But when you get out of it, though, that testimony you have, when you get through it, that testimony you have, listen, it's going to be great. It's going to be wonderful. I'm telling you, don't stop. Don't quit. Don't give up on things that people want you to give up on. Go for what you're going for. I know I said quite a bit, but I know a lot of people may not hear it, or they may take it and just like, you know, yeah, okay. A lot of folks are scared to step out there. And I'm not talking about step out into this world. I'm talking about step out on some things you've been holding back from. It's been keeping. It's a conversation you need to have, a tough conversation you need to have with somebody, but you're afraid to have that tough conversation with them because you don't know what the outcome is going to be. Pray about it. Sit down and have a conversation with the person and move on from it. Whatever is taken away from it or you going through with it, let that be what it is. I will say that I will be posting the information on the podcast. I do have new podcast platforms that God's Day is a part of that I found out about last week and I didn't even know. So I will be posting that information as quickly as I can. I can't make no promises today. But I will be posting the latest podcast platforms that we are a part of, as well as I still have more podcast episodes to upload, but as well as all the information that we talked about, getting jobs, helping people get jobs, resources, folks, helping people with their bills, utility bills, their rent, getting whatever we can to help people out as much as we can, even food. We're going into Thanksgiving, and we want to make sure that people have food on their tables, not just for Thanksgiving, but every day. If there's something that you're doing, your church is doing, they don't mind sharing and putting it out there to other people, send me that information. Let's put it out there. Even if you got a promo video, even if you got a flyer or something, send me that information, godsday81@gmail.com, godsday81@gmail.com. Those that are on the podcast, you can do the same thing as well. Remember to follow us on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, and Pinterest. And don't forget about the podcast, as well as email us if you want to be a guest, you have information, you want to talk about your business, send me the information or let me know. Send me an email at godsday81@gmail.com. Let's support each other. Let's be there for each other. Also, we do have a YouTube channel which is Whispers in the Pews. Please subscribe to our YouTube channel. It's an all-purpose YouTube. Like, we do some of everything. So you might see me and the grand girl on there with our little theme song or whatever. So we like to have fun and just do little things like that. I got some more videos with me and Hud making up songs and stuff. So just, you know, so just go and subscribe to our YouTube channel as well. And when you go to our GodsDay81.com website, please sign up to be on our email subscribers list. And like I said before, we're going to be doing a drawing or whatever for the email subscribers as well. And plus you get, hey, how are you? Guys, say, we're going to be putting some, the email subscribers that sign up to be a part of our email subscribers list will be a part of a drawing that I'm doing. It's nothing big, nothing out of the ordinary, but we will be doing that, in just a little bit. But I wanted to make sure that I gave everybody the opportunity to go and be on the Guys Day, GodsDay81.com email subscribers list. You'll be the first to know about any new blogs that we have, any new products that come out, anything that goes on with Guys Day, you'll be the first to know. With that being said, Guys Day has Guys Day t-shirts. They are $12. You can go to the website and you can order you one today for men and women. You can have one. You can go to our website and they are $12 and they're size small to extra large. As well as we have the Guys Day journals here. Guys Day journals come with an ink pen. It comes with an ink pen, see? And you can, the ink pen goes in on the side. These are $5. Has the logo, has the elastic. And these are things that you can write in. It has like the notebook paper. These are things that you can write in. You can put your notes in, your prayers, your scriptures, any type of like jotting down anything. And it has a bookmark thing to keep your place. But these fit in your purse, in your bag, in your pocket. You can take these with you and you can write down whatever information you want to write down. The information, if you want to order those, you can go to my website. Again, those are $5. You can go to my website, GodsDay81.com, GodsDay81.com, and you can put your order in for your Guys Day journals. These are great stocking stuffers. Christmas is around the corner. You can go ahead and get you some before I run out. And you can order yours today. And I will send it over to you. And you can give it out to a friend and say, hey, this is something that I just wanted to give, or something extra that I wanted to give to you. So these are great things that you can have. Excuse me, I'm going upside. I'm going to have this mask on, but I'm still here. But this is great information, or a great product that you can use, you can have. Okay. So there will be great information that you can have. And again, great stocking stuffers for your family. Sorry, y'all. I was just trying to prepare myself to get out of here. Give me just one more second. I'm still here. All right. Okay, I'm still here. So again, you have your business or information, you have an event going on. I'm trying to switch hands here so I can look at y'all. If you have an event going on,
you have your business you need support from, you got something going on with you, yours, your family or whatever, send me the information so that we can support you with your business. As long as it's something positive, I don't mind supporting you and sharing your information. Because we're trying to make sure everything stay on the positive side. There's enough negative stuff. There's enough of the stuff that we don't need to be showing to our kids and stuff. I know they'll be introduced to it, but if you don't help introduce stuff before this their time, they don't need to know about, then yeah. So again, let's support and help each other out as much as we possibly can. Again, my email address is godsday81@gmail.com. godsday81@gmail.com. Follow me on Facebook, Twitter, Pinterest, Instagram, YouTube. The link will be attached to this video. You will be able to click on it. Follow us on all the social media platforms, as well as follow us or listen to our podcast platform as well. You'll have the opportunity to do that because the link will be attached. Our email address will be there. Our website will be there. Go and check out the website. Sign up for our email subscribers list. Woo! Do all those good things. I want y'all to have an amazing day, a wonderful day. Think positive. Stay positive. Don't let nobody or nothing change you. Continue to be that wonderful. Continue to be that wonderful person that you are. Don't let that switch up. Don't let that change you. Don't let that stop you. Keep going. I'm about to waste this summer, y'all. Hold on a minute. Thank you. Thank you. Don't let that stop you. Don't let that change you. Keep being the great person that you are. Keep doing positive things. Keep holding your head up. Don't let nothing stop you or block you from doing the great things that you've been doing. God is watching. You can go ahead. No, you're good. You're good. Go ahead. God is watching. He's paying attention to you. He's listening to your prayers. Don't stop because you don't think it's working. Don't stop because you don't see no growth. Keep going. If it's one person on your life, keep going. Don't let that stop you. Y'all hold on a minute. I'm almost there. It's so his waist. Good morning. Good morning. Good morning. Good morning. Good morning. Good morning. Hi. Hi. Your new coworker.
Okay. 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 Ok Keep being that loving person. Don't try. God is listening to you. He wants you to do the great things you've been doing. Go. Have a great rest of y'all day. Remember, God loves you. I love you. And this is the only way. Talk to you later.